I just finished filming, editing, and uploading a new kind of main video about spinal instability, which is something that I've actually been wanting to make a video on since I started my channel. That was actually one of the main reasons I started it. I was going to make that video. But then my life was just kind of crazy. I was still having problems with instability and fusions, and I wasn't quite sure what I wanted to say because I didn't want to like say anything and then like a couple months or a couple weeks later not feel the same way. But now I feel like I am in a very stable place with my surgery and my recovery, so I feel like it's time. And this one was kind of just like a factual one. Pretty soon I'm going to be filming a video on my experience and my journey with spinal instability and spinal fusions. So that should be quite interesting. I'm kind of a private person and I have compiled a bunch of little videos that I've taken over the years before and after surgeries and stuff like that. But I haven't decided how much of that I really want to share. I'm a little bit torn because I feel like the more I share, the more I'm doing to help raise awareness and help people to understand and help people to get diagnosed. But then at the same time, that comes at a bit of a personal cost when it comes to my own pride and vulnerability. So, I just have to try to find that balance. I'll probably start piecing stuff together. And then we'll see where it goes from there. I might save it until May because May is Ehlers-Danlos Awareness Month, and I kind of want to make a video for that, so maybe I'll combine those. I am just glad that I got this video done with because, like I said, I've been planning it forever, but also I have a really busy week this week, and I knew if I didn't get it done today, it wasn't gonna get done. So now I'm just procrastinating all of the other things I need to do. Fingers crossed, tomorrow is the day that I am getting my new knee brace. We have to call him in the morning and see if they were able to get it in stock. But the guy who makes my braces, his office is a couple hours away, but it's like right near my physical therapy place. So if he doesn't have it tomorrow, I have to wait until at least Friday for my next PT appointment. Yeah, I really hope they have it tomorrow. I need to function. So, total bummer. The knee brace is not available yet today. Oh, I was really, really hoping that it would be because there's some things I wanted to do this week and it's been really nice. I wanted to get outside for a walk and oh well, I have to wait till Friday and that's fine. I was really hoping for some relief, but it is what it is. It is starting to look like it's probably not going to heal like I hoped it would. I've been having problems where even though my kneecap is still in place, it kind of gets stopped and won't go any further. It feels like something's stuck in there, which is always my worst nightmare. I'm thinking that maybe I broke off a piece of the cartilage or the meniscus. My physical therapist also mentioned that today. That's probably what's going on. And it's just not really an injury that can heal on its own. And though you can do physical therapy to manage it, the only real way to get it out of the joint is to have surgery. And like I mentioned, I'm not really a good candidate for joint surgery, so that would not be a decision to be taken lightly. The hope is that with the bracing and the physical therapy, it'll be enough for me to manage my symptoms. I have tried so hard not to hurt my meniscus, but with EDS, you can be so careful. And then one day I just stepped down on it wrong. And there you go. It's unfortunate, but it is the reality.
Hi guys, it is Wednesday now. I had kind of an exciting day. I got to go out and meet a friend that I had made on Instagram. She has EDS and POTS and mast cell, and she's got a feeding tube too. So it was just like really cool to finally get to meet her in person. We live super close together, but we had never met before. And last night I got to FaceTime with another girl I met through this. So it just makes me really happy when I get to connect with you guys. Even though I've never met like 99% of you, I like really and truly consider all of you guys my friends. Anyway, it is just so super nice out today. It's getting kind of cold now, but it's been really nice out. So I'm just trying to get as much time in the fresh air as possible. I am so happy because I thought I had a doctor's appointment today, but I actually have a doctor's appointment next Wednesday. So I get the day off today. Whoa, my hair looks really red in this light. It's kind of weird. The henna only shows up like in natural light. But I'm not in natural light very much.
So I was just sitting here and thinking about my day and thinking about just how lucky I have been to have had the chance to meet so many amazing people who are going through some of the same things that I am. I really get so much out of my friendships with other Zebras, and a lot of you guys have told me that you have never actually been able to meet another person with the same condition as you, and that makes me kind of sad. I wish that I could meet each and every one of you and give you a hug, but luckily we have this amazing online community. I really am so thankful for each and every one of you, but if you feel comfortable with it, you could maybe post where you're from and what condition you have, and who knows, somebody else might live right down the street from you. Sometimes it is a small world. No, oh, look at that. Sammy, are you tired? Sam, you tired?
Guys, I got a package in the mail today, and I think I know what it is. That is so cute. I love this. Oh my gosh. A really nice viewer named Thomas contacted me and told me that he and an artist friend had put together an Other Standless Awareness t-shirt and was wondering if I wanted one. I was like, of course, yes, please. So he sent me one, and I am totally wearing it to PT tomorrow. It is so cute. Oh my goodness. They are actually for sale, so they have tons of sizes and colors. You can buy them on Amazon. I will link that down below. I just think it is so super cute. I love this little zebra guy on here. Especially perfect because it's only 1 month until Ehlers-Danlos Awareness Month. I'm trying to think of some cool ideas of what to do. I definitely am going to make a video like I did last year, but I'm looking for some other ideas, maybe looking to collaborate. I don't know. If you guys have any ideas, definitely leave them in the comments and we can talk about it. I think that we should do something really cool. And thank you so much again, Tommy. The shirt's adorable. You guys should get one. Then we can be twins. We can form our own little zebra army.
Oh, it is so cute. Look at him. I feel like he needs a name. Oh, that's so sweet. I'm gonna go represent at physical therapy. I'll see you guys later.
Hi guys, it's now later in the day on Friday and it is so beautiful out. I just had to come and spend some time outside. There is nothing like a little bit of fresh air. So I just got back from physical therapy and also I got to pick up my brand new knee brace. Woohoo! So far, it's really awesome. It's super comfortable. I think it feels like exactly what I needed. The only thing is this brace isn't specifically designed to stop hyperextension. He said that because I'm so small, this brace might be just bulky enough to keep me from hyperextending. So we'll have to see about that. But so far it feels great. There are hinges in it. He actually took the hinges out of it and bent them and then put them back in so that now they fit the contours of my leg. I kind of have a little itty bitty leg, so the hinges were kind of gapping and hitting places that they shouldn't have been, and so now it feels great.
Guys, I'm gonna be honest, I'm getting a little bit frustrated with these mast cell activation issues. I just can't help but feeling a little bit trapped. You know, I keep thinking, oh, like it's getting so much better and I'm not as sensitive, and so I can start exposing myself to things again. And while that is true, I am so much better. It's just kind of scary that at any second it can just hit again. Like yesterday, I was just kind of sitting in the front room. My sister got out of the bathtub and I guess she had used some kind of bath product that bothered me, and she walked in. And, you know, at that point I was like, oh, I can smell it. I'm going to leave the room. But then I started to notice my legs felt really, really weak, and I started to feel really weird. So I walked back in the room to talk to my mom to say, hey, you know, this is going on. I don't feel right. And the next thing I knew, I was fainting and shaking, and it's just difficult. It's scary for me, and it makes me feel like, oh, I have to stay in my room where it is safe. But to be honest, my room isn't even safe, because if someone's cooking something, even if they're cooking something downstairs, it somehow gets in, and we have all of these air cleaners and purifiers, and I have masks. We take all of the necessary precautions. I take all of my medications. I do all my treatments, and it's just not enough. We have tried turning my bedroom into a positive pressure room, meaning that no air can come in, only out. But for some reason, that hasn't really been able to stop the smells getting in. We have even had to cover the outside of my windows with plastic sheeting so the smell of my neighbor's wood-burning stove can't seep in. Even sometimes that doesn't work. I don't know. That is such a frustrating feeling when you are doing absolutely everything you can be doing and it's not enough. But I do still have a lot of hope. Like I said, it is so much better than it was, and now I am on these Xolair injections. I get my next Xolair injection next week, so I'm excited about that, and I'm excited to hopefully move closer and closer to recovery. But right now, it's just frustrating, and it's frustrating for our whole family because they feel like they can't cook and they can't eat. Mostly, it's difficult for my sister. She's just trying to live her life, and I'm allergic to everything, and we happen to live in the same house. She's a teenage girl, and she wants to wear perfume, and she wants to smell nice, and I get that. But then I also get really frustrated because I'm like, this is dangerous, and like, I could die. I could get really sick. Can you please, you know, make some changes? And she has made a lot of changes. My whole family has. But, you know, you just can't control everybody and everyone's behavior. So that's my little rant right now. I am just so tired. My body is just in recovery mode, and I feel kind of like I got hit by a bus. I don't really know what the solution is at this point. We are just taking it one day at a time, 1 minute at a time, 1 second at a time. And we are trying to remain very thankful for every single day and minute and second that I am feeling well. It is Saturday, and it is so nice out. It is like 70 degrees. Oh, it is perfect. I wish it was this weather all the time. But anyway, I decided that I was going to go for a walk. I need some packing supplies for some Etsy orders, and we have a Staples like a couple blocks away, so I decided to venture out. I can't actually remember the last time that I walked anywhere alone. To be honest, probably like years back when I used to take the bus home from school and I would walk home from the bus stop. So this is pretty cool. It's funny because I spend most of my time alone, but I spend very little time doing anything alone, if that makes sense. These last few years, it just wasn't really safe for me to be on my own. So this is kind of a big step. Thank you, knee brace. When I decided to take the buy one, get one half off deal on these things, I guess I kind of forgot that I was going to have to walk home with them. Oh well. I survived. Plus one for personal independence. Hi guys, I hope you are having a lovely Sunday. It is time again to wrap up another weekly vlog. Thank you guys so very much for watching and following along on my week. We just hit 5,000 subscribers. 5,000. I can't even believe it. I don't know what to say. Thank you guys so much. Hello to anyone who is new around here. Oh, also look. I finished my blanket. You probably can't see it. I just have to make the tassels for the corners, and then I am done. And also, I had some leftover yarn, so Now I have a hat.
Anyway, you know the drill. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. If you want to be notified when I upload a video, you can click the little bell next to my name. And I will see you guys next week. Goodbye.